Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the November 22nd, 2020 service for First Congregational United Church of Christ of Zumbrota. This is our pre-Thanksgiving service. And in these times of transition and change, as we go from one part of the year to another part of the year, and as we live new lives because of COVID-19 for the next month or so, it's so nice to be able to be together. It's a real blessing, and I'm so thankful. And I'm so thankful that all of you are here after the service to help us set up the Christmas trees. And if anyone is watching on Facebook Live, it is about 9:35, and we're not going to start setting up the trees until 10:30. So even if you were in Rochester or Cannon Falls or even Minneapolis, you still have time. The traffic is going to be just fine. You still have time to come and help us. Are there any announcements today? I have a number of announcements. The first is that we lost Jim Wedge a couple of weeks ago, and his funeral was scheduled to take place on the 28th, Saturday, but it has been postponed due to COVID-19, and I will let you know when that is going to take place. I know that Jim was an incredibly powerful member of our church community and in the Zumbrota community, and I know that we will want to pay our respects when that is time for his life celebration. My second announcement is that I oftentimes talk about vision and perspective and how we look at things. And today is really an example of that. And here's what I mean. This morning when I got up and walked Scout, Minneapolis had about an inch of snow on the ground. And it was beautiful. And I know that a person could get up and see the snow and think that it's too early for snow and that it will require shoveling and it will be a nuisance and will make the roads slippery. And we can look at it that way. Those are valid ways to look at it. But we can also look at it as being beautiful and something out of the ordinary and something fresh. It depends upon how we're going to look at things. And that goes to our lives too. So, when Governor Walz places restrictions on us, restrictions that affect our movement and our lives, it's easy to look at them and think, I'm inconvenienced, and I have limits on what I can do. And that is a way to look at it. we enter a period of lockdown, basically, we have to be more disciplined than we have been. And we need to keep our distance and wear our masks. And we can't be together the way that we would like. But we can do it. We are able to sacrifice in order to keep each other safe and in order to stop what's happening. We can do it. And we in this community have the ability to continue to meet while this is going on, and that great thing isn't available to everybody. So let's keep that in mind. I want to thank David and Sandy and Amy and Paul and their families for working so hard on the Christmas trees and the wreaths. It would not be the same thing without these families and what they've done. And speaking for myself and for everybody in this community, thank you very much. My last announcement is this. When we live our lives, and events happen to us in our days, sometimes we might miss an opportunity to see God. As you know, Martha has been facing cancer treatment, and she's been undergoing chemotherapy. Well, this week, she had a test, and the test showed that the cancer was gone. And the doctor was astounded. The doctor hadn't seen that before. And she's not gone through her entire session of chemotherapy. She's about at the halfway point. And as I said, the cancer is gone. I'll speak for her. And I don't think I'm wrong. That's God in her life. It's something that isn't explainable with medical science. It's something new and something spectacular that happened. The examples of God in our lives might not be so dramatic, but maybe they will be sometime. But let's keep our eyes open and our ears open, and let's be open for what might happen and what God wants us to do. Amen. Will you please stand if you are able and bow your heads for our prayer of invocation. God, keep our heads above water. Give us the determination and the perseverance and the strength to continue swimming, even if we do not see the shore. The shore is out there, in front of us, just out of our view. Amen. Please join me in singing hymn 419, Now Thank We All Our God. Please join me in the unison prayer. Jesus, encourage us to continue to do your will. Encourage us to learn the things that you want from us and the confidence to act. We are the people who must change the world. Amen. Please be seated and join me in singing another great Thanksgiving hymn. That is hymn 421, We Gather Together. Thank you. take some time, blink, and breathe in and out, and get settled and peaceful as we listen to the Word of God and listen for what God is saying to us. The page numbers for the readings will be in parentheses behind the reading, if you'd care to follow along. First reading is from Ezekiel 34, verses 1 through 16, page 702. In this reading, Ezekiel is warning Israel regarding good shepherds and false shepherds. The word of the Lord came to me. Mortal, prophesy against the shepherds of Israel. Prophesy and say to them, to the shepherds, thus says the Lord God, I, you shepherds of Israel who have been feeding yourselves, should not shepherds feed the sheep? You eat the fat, you clothe yourselves with the wool, you slaughter the fatlings, but you do not feed the sheep. You have not strengthened the weak, you have not healed the sick, you have not bound up the injured, you have not brought back the strayed, you have not sought the lost, but with force and harshness you have ruled them. So they were scattered because there was no shepherd. And scattered they became food for all the wild animals. My sheep were scattered. They wandered over all the mountains and on every high hill. My sheep were scattered over all the face of the earth, with no one to search or to seek for them. Therefore, you shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. As I live, says the Lord God, because my sheep have become a prey, and my sheep have become food for all the wild animals since there was no shepherd, and because my shepherds have not searched for my sheep, but the shepherds fed themselves, and have not fed my sheep, therefore, you shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God, I am against the shepherds, and I will demand my sheep at their hand, and put a stop to their feeding the sheep. No longer shall my shepherds feed themselves. I will rescue my sheep from their mouths so that they may not be food for them. For thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out. As shepherds seek out their flocks when they are among the scattered sheep, so I will seek out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries and will bring them into their own land, and I will feed them on the mountains of Israel, by the water courses and in all the inhabited parts of the land. I will feed them with good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel shall be their pasture. And they shall lie down in good grazing land, and they shall feed on rich pasture on the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I will make them lie down, says the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak. But the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them with justice. Our gospel reading today is from Matthew. Chapter 25, verses 31 to 46, on page 807. Jesus is talking about the judgment of the nations, just as Ezekiel was talking about judgment in the reading from Ezekiel. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people, one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, "Come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me." Then the righteous will answer him, "Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you?" And the king will answer them, "Truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these, who are members of my family, you did it to me." Then he will say to those at his left hand, "You that are accursed, depart from me into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger and you did not welcome me. Naked and you did not give me clothing. Sick and in prison and you did not visit me." Then they will also answer, "Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not take care of you?" Then he will answer them, "Truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me." And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life. This ends the reading. two readings, severe readings, difficult readings, talking about judgment. And so I'm going to talk about judgment. The title of my sermon today is called Punching Above Our Weight. I am not a boxing fan. But what the phrase means is this: that if you were a boxer and you weigh a certain amount, let's say 150 pounds, you can fight in that weight class. If you want, you can fight in a higher weight class with heavier fighters, but you cannot drop down to a lower weight class. So when someone says that people are punching above their weight, what it means is that they have more power than you would expect by looking at them. I love that phrase. So I titled my sermon that, and then I had to find some scriptural basis to help. As I mentioned earlier, this week Governor Walz has issued orders shutting down a lot of businesses in our state. And I watched the press conference, and it was obvious that this was a difficult decision for Governor Walz, and that he struggled with it, and that he knows what it means for everyday people to have their lives disrupted. Many of us are scared. And that's a natural response. And that's okay. It's what we do with it that really matters in life. We're one people. And we're here for each other. In this church, in this community, in this state, in this country, and in this world. We're here for each other. At First Congregational, we are ready, willing, and able to help people in need. And as pastor of this church, my cell phone and email can be found on the website, and if there's anything that I can do, or if people want to talk, I welcome that opportunity. At First Congregational, how are we punching above our weight? There are not so many of us. What are we doing? I look outside my window and I see the Christmas trees that we are selling. And that's going to cheer up a lot of people. going back into the community. And we had an ice cream social a couple of months ago. And we met a lot of people in the community, and a lot of you were there. And we're letting people know who we are and what we stand for and what we do in the world. That this is a place where we are here one for another. It's important for us to live out the words that we read in the scriptures. Ezekiel was talking about shepherds who did not feed the sheep but fed themselves, and the judgment that the Lord was going to give to those shepherds. People who were concerned with themselves and not concerned with others. And Jesus said basically the same thing in Matthew. Now, this is the important thing that I took from the reading in Matthew. There weren't two different animals. There weren't sheep and goats. No, there was one people. Some fed the hungry. Some gave water to the thirsty. Some clothed the naked. Jesus says, what you do to the least of these, you do to me. Giving back, giving to others. Without thought for self, but thinking of others. When we are at our best, that's what we're doing. And I'm proud to say in this congregation we're often at our best. We're good at punching above our weight. Thanks be to God. Please join me in singing hymn 422.
Song of harvest tone. We'll be participating in what's called the Goodhue County Christmas Project again this year, which serves about 300 families in Goodhue County. And we have three families that will be supporting all living in Zumbrota. And my prayer is that a prayer of gratitude that we have the opportunity to, another opportunity to serve the community.
Thank you. Anything else?
COVID did a little bit close to home now for us, because Connie's dad has it in the nursing home in South Dakota. They were hit pretty hard. They had over 18 cases, staff and patients. So keep them in our prayers along with all the rest of the people in this country that are in the world that are suffering.
Thank you. Would you please bow your heads and join me in prayers of the people? God, we know that with you, anything can happen. We should always have hope and optimism and perseverance to do our best, because you are with us. You are always with us. We ask for your special care for all of the people and the families who have been affected by COVID-19. Help them recover, God. And help them celebrate, and help them mourn. We pray for your special care for the 900 healthcare workers in the Mayo system, for healthcare workers, people who drive our trucks and work in our stores, people whose job is to help keep us safe. Please bless them and strengthen them. And let us follow the best practices to keep as many people possible. Keep as many people safe as it is possible, God. We pray for Jim Wedge's family as they go through this period of transition. Please help us as we mourn Jim's passing. We pray for Connie and Bob, Connie's dad and his family, all of the people affected by COVID in South Dakota, in that home. We keep them in our prayers, God. God, thank you for allowing us to help others. Whether it's the three families in Zumbrota for Christmas, or the people whose Christmas is going to be a little bit brighter because they'll have a tree and they can gather around it and think. But all the love in the world and all the love that we have for them. We pray for those who cannot regularly meet with us on Sunday mornings. We pray in thanksgiving for Martha's recovery. We pray for courage and strength for my brother Jeff as he undergoes cancer surgery. Please comfort him and give him peace. Please strengthen those of us who are suffering but do not know a way to reach out. Please give them the courage to take this step to reach out to us. Please give us the grace to respond in kind. We celebrate 5 birthdays in Parker's family. We pray for all during this Thanksgiving season. May it be rich, even though it is different. And may we each take some time and think about our lives and what we're doing with our lives and ways we can help others. We pray for support and recognition for those who have served in the armed services, the men and the women who have sacrificed so that we can live in this beautiful and free country. Please join me in praying as Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Now please stand if you are able, and let's greet one another. We can't hug or shake hands, but we can wave and let each other know how important and how vital you are for us in our lives. Please join me in singing the peace song, which is on the inside back cover of the black hymnal. Teach us that what is ours is really yours, and what is yours is really ours. Amen. Please join me in singing hymn 423, only verses 1 and 2. Great is your faithfulness.
Great is your faithfulness, O Lord.
let's keep doing what we need to do, what we're called to do, what we know is right. Let's keep doing it and keep punching above our weight.